wanted to post this, but I thought I'd rather just read it, yani venye naweza ielewa. So it's all about irresponsible cancel culture and an irresponsible way to push the hashtag play KE music by Muthoni Drama Queen. So Muthoni posted her response to Boomplay on her story after they had posted a post promoting Wa Diamond song, which he features Koffi Olomide. Her response was that Koffi Olomide is a convicted rapist and Boomplay need to de-platform Wa, and they should stop putting the promotion budget behind an abuser. First thing I would love to highlight is the timing of this. I'm not consigning what Koffi Olomide did, but also I'm not going to say I'm never going to play his music again. Because trust me, my introduction to music was through Rumba. I remember in my pre-unit nursery, shitting on my pants days, how much I danced to Koffi Olomide and Awilo. With that, realize it's going to be hard for me to give up the legend Koffi as one of my Rumba heroes. Let's go to the timing of this though. I believe the real motive, the hidden agenda behind MDQ's post was her fight for hashtag play KE music. She's the third Kenyan celebrity now who have taken shots at Wa since it dropped. First, it was Joe Muchiri, who seemed disgusted when it was televised when Uhuru Kenyatta, our president, dancing to Eat. Then came Mr. Ohanga Don Papichulo, Mr. Octopizzo, who took shots at Diamond by posting, and I quote, "Mother fathers out here gassing Diamond but will not support Otile Brown. The mediocrity on this platform." Then I believe he shook his head. Yep, super pissed. There were some few Twitter fingers here and there, response from Diamond's camp, and a diplomatic move from the big bad bull, Otile Brown, who basically said, support who you like, support what you like. Music has no boundaries. Then now Muthoni, the drama queen, who pulled the hashtag Me Too shot at Wa. But first, let me clarify this. MDQ is right about Koffi Olomide. Because in 2012, Koffi was first charged with aggravated rape, but the charges were reduced. If you read the full story, the legend has a record sheet worth and Harvey Weinstein and R. Kelly sentencing. But how MDQ is going about it, it's not going to work. Because personally, now her truth has been drowned in her subjective hidden agenda. That's what I call pure irresponsible. Because I would love to ask her, where was the energy when Petra's music dropped featuring a convicted murderer? Oh, we know. Has she come out to clarify the poorly planned blanket and wines coffees event with poor lighting on the grounds and lack of enough security guards that led to gross misconduct? Because according to one witness, a drunken lady was being groped by several men. Did Muthoni Drama queue as an event organizer, and I believe an owner of blankets and wine, care about the security of the people who attended her overpriced event? Because if I'm going to get value for my money, I need security. Security needs to be part of the need list, manze, or things that zinafaa kukua major. So as I finish up this, I want to say I love Muthoni Drama Queen's music. I empathize with her, with how she feels, but I don't agree with her ideology and how she's fighting for it in this particular case. I also believe we can intensify the plight of hashtag play Kenya music, but we should be objective and sober with the way we go about it. Not the way Joe and Muthoni Drama Queen are so far going about it. So this is the Omuya's Cast podcast. Let's debate. Follow me Facebook, Twitter, my WhatsApp. Yeah, Instagram. Let's debate. Do you agree with me or do you disagree with me? And do you agree to disagree with me?